We've all heard of plastic. We've also heard about how bad it is and how it is polluting the world. I couldn't help but wonder why plastic was even invented when the world was just happy using natural products. So I did some research and I found some very interesting information about the history of plastic, which I'll be sharing with you in this video. At the end of this video, I'll also be sharing a few tips on how we can use plastics more sustainably, so stay tuned to find out. In 1862, Alexander Parkes introduced the world's first ever man-made plastic called Parksene. This was not a commercial success, but it was an important step in the development of plastic. The need for a synthetic material like plastic was felt around the 1860s when the billiards game was gaining a lot of popularity. The billiards balls were made from natural ivory by slaughtering wild elephants. There were also other products during this time that were made from tortoise shells, animal horns, and so on. The high demand for these products increased poaching and threatened the lives of the animals. This also put a strain on their supply. In 1869, a New York firm offered $10,000 for anyone who could provide a substitute for ivory. Inspired by this offer, John Wesley Hyatt invented an improved version of Parksene called celluloid that could replace natural materials. Hyatt made the discovery by treating cellulose derived from cotton fiber with camphor. This discovery was revolutionary and opened up so many new opportunities. Ironically, it was created to protect the environment, and it was even praised as a savior of the elephant and the tortoise. One drawback, however, was that celluloid was highly flammable. This problem was later solved with the invention of Bakelite by Leo Baekeland in 1907, which was a fully synthetic plastic with no molecules found in nature. After this successful invention, many chemical companies started inventing different kinds of plastic for different purposes, like polyethylene, polystyrene, nylon, and so on. These synthetic materials seemed like a great alternative to natural resources which could be preserved. It was also cheap, which made it accessible to many. It replaced wood in furniture, steel in cars, glass in bottles, and soon plastic found its way into every industry. This overconsumption brought out the issues that we are all aware of today. Plastic debris was everywhere, and major oil spills revealed the harmful nature of its raw materials. The world realized that plastic was not the flawless material that they thought it was. It was at this time that the plastic industry offered recycling as a solution. But recycling is far from being perfect. If you want to know more about the problems with recycling, you can check the video on my channel. I'll leave a link in the description. We are struggling with the plastic problem till date, and we are finding it hard to break free from this versatile material. But maybe the problem is not the material itself, but the way we use it. I think the lesson to be learned from the story of plastic is that too much of anything is bad for the environment. What started as a well-intentioned attempt to preserve the environment is now threatening it. Now, there are some amazing alternatives to plastic that are coming up in the market. But we have to remember to use them within the limits, so that we don't end up creating a disaster like plastic all over again. Now, as promised in the beginning of the video, I'll share a few tips on how we can use plastics more sustainably. Number one is reducing consumption of single-use plastic. Plastic is very durable and it's not best suited as a single-use material. So whenever possible, it is good to choose a reusable option instead of single-use items. For example, carrying a reusable water bottle from home can help us avoid plastic packaged water. Or we can carry our own bags to the grocery store to avoid plastic bags. Number two is taking care of the plastic products that we already own. Let's face it, we all have plastic in our homes. All this plastic has already caused a lot of pollution during production. Throwing it away will only lead to more pollution. So the best we can do is to take good care of it and reuse it for as long as we can. As long as the product is in good condition and it is safe and comfortable to use, there is no need to throw it away and buy an alternative just to go plastic free. Besides, the alternative product will also require energy to be produced and to reach our homes, which can be avoided. Number 3 is recycling. Recycling is not going to solve the plastic problem, but when we do end up with plastic waste, we can give them for recycling so that they don't end up in the landfills, at least not immediately. If you're a fan of DIY, plastic waste can also be upcycled into useful products or can even be made into eco bricks. I have a video about eco bricks in the description as well, so you can have a look if you're interested. Number 4 is conscious consumption. Many times, we buy things we may not really need. Just by being more conscious and avoiding things that we don't need can be a great start to a sustainable lifestyle. So that's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed watching it. If you did, please give a like and share your comments below. Do subscribe to the channel for more videos like this. Thank you for watching.